they came between Trinity Baptist College and your Thomas University Nighthawks. Thomas University, the Southern States Athletic Conference, and the NAIA would like to take this opportunity to encourage you to help everyone enjoy this afternoon's contest of being a true champion of character by displaying respect and good sportsmanship to all involved. You can create a positive environment for the team and the family. Profanity, racial, sexist, or other intimidating acts at the players, officials, coaches, or other fans will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of this competition. Flag photography is also prohibited during live competition, and fans are not allowed on the field at any time. Now, let's meet our visitors from Jacksonville, Florida. Leading off playing center field, number 11, Jacob Irvin. Batting second, lane catcher, number 14, Ryan Onsk. Batting third, the designated hitter, number 9, Gavin Williams. Batting fourth, the right fielder, number 2, Jordan Fernandez. Batting fifth, left fielder, number 10, Parker Lester. Batting sixth, the second baseman, number 41, Seth Reed. Batting seventh, third baseman, number 12, Corey Ross. Batting eighth, first baseman, number 24, Darren Gold. And batting nine, the shortstop, number 8, Logan McGann. Today's starting pitcher will be Andrew Moeller, number 6. Trinity Baptist is coached by John Copeland, assistant coach Jordan Brown. Number 24, Casey Moody. Batting second, your shortstop, number 23, Mike Sowers. Batting third, left fielder, number 14, Max Rickard. Your cleanup hitter, the designated hitter, number 21, Nick Kuchesko. That is good. Play first base, number 6, Jake T. Watley. That is good. Play third base, number 7, Easton Willis. That is 7, the center fielder, number 33, Dave Sebasti. That is 8, play second base, number 5, Turner Maddox. That is 9, your catcher, number 1, Cameron Zorio. And starting on the bump today, number 12, Brad Peacock. Coach of the Nighthawks, head coach Tom Flanorn, assistant coaches Reed Brown, Fernando Gonzalez, Owen Taylor, and Alex Freeman. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise if you can, and gentlemen, remove your caps, as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
welcome to Barnado Stadium. The first game of a doubleheader between the Trinity Baptist College Eagles and the Thomas University Nighthawks. Just about getting ready to get started here. We'll play two games this afternoon, seven-inning games, both of them. This one's about to get underway and then play another one this evening, probably around 7 o'clock. Let's take a look at the defense for the Nighthawks. Starting on the mound is number 12, Brad Peacock. He'll be pitching to Cameron Rosario, the catcher, in game one. Easton Willis over at third. Mike Sowers at short. Turner Maddox at second. And J.T. Watley over at first. The outfield will be Max Pickard in left. Gabe Tefelski in center. And Kaysen Bowie in right field. Leading off for the Eagles, center fielder Jacob Burke. And the first pitch is drilled right back up the middle. Base hit, Jacob Burke. So for the Eagles, Jacob Burke led off. It'll be Ryan Onks, the catcher, batting second. Gavin Williams DHing in this game, batting third. Jordan Fernandez in right. It'll be Parker Laffrey, left fielder. Seth Reeve, second baseman. Zachary Ross, third base. Batting eighth will be Darren Goki, the first baseman. And Logan McGann, shortstop, batting ninth. And the first pitch to Ox is a little bit of high ball one. On the mound for Trinity Baptist is Andrew Moeller. That pitch just missed a little bit outside, 2-0 now to Angst. That fastball's in there for a strike. Two balls and a strike now. Pitch missed a little low, 3-1 now. That ball's hit in the air to left field, and over to catch it is Max Pickard for the first out of the inning. Burke retreats back to first base. That'll bring up the designated hitter, Gavin Williams. So Peacock's making his 16th appearance of the season. All in relief. One-on-one record with a 5.47 ERA. There's a strike called. Okay. The 0-1 is curveball hit on to the right side. See if Wiley has room. He doesn't. It's fouling out of play, so no balls, two strikes. So no balls, two strikes. One out here, just getting started, top of the first inning. Runner at first base is Jacob Burke. He led things off with a single. On the first pitch of the game, then Ryan Onks hit a line drive to left field, but that was caught by Max Pickard. The 0-2 is outside to Gavin Williams. So Peacock, 24 and two-thirds innings pitched, and now make it an even 25. He's got the first out of this game, 25 innings pitched. Opponent's batting 295. Again, there goes the runner. There's a ball high. The throw down is going to be not in time. Safe is Jacob Burke. For Burke, that's his fifth stolen base of the season. I mean, it'll be a two-ball, two-strike count now. To the right-hand batter, Gavin Williams. That ball's fouled off the catcher's mask, and home plate umpire will walk a new baseball out to Brad Peacock. The count remains 2 balls, 2 strikes. Degrees and sunny here in Thomasville, Georgia, as we start the doubleheader. Not much wind to speak of. And cloudy skies, but don't think there's any threat of rain tonight. Here's the 2-2, and that's a called strike three. Nice pitch by Peacock to catch the inside corner. And Williams goes down looking for the second out of the first inning. Now to bring up the right fielder, Jordan Fernandez. With the runner at second base, but now 2 outs. There's a good slider there by Peacock for a called strike one. Fernandez batting 318 on the season. Leads the team in RBIs, and he's got an RBI opportunity here in the first inning. The 0-1 is hit on the ground and numbered to second base. Maddox fields it cleanly and throws over to first to retire the side. So Trinity Baptist gets a base hit. There are no errors and one runner left on base. We've played a half inning. Your score, Trinity Baptist 0, Thomas University coming to bat. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Due up for the Nighthawks in the bottom of the first will be Kason Bowie, Mike Sowers, and Max Pickard. And they'll be facing right-handed pitcher Andrew Moeller for the Eagles. Moeller making his 14th appearance on the season, 20 innings even pitched. As it leads the team in ERA 2.70 and also WHIP 1.45. As he gets a start in game one of our doubleheader. Moeller out of Dade City, Florida, Pasco High School. Freshman for the Eagles. Kason Bowie steps in to lead off of the Nighthawks, setting up the defense for TBC. Moeller on the mound, who will be pitching to Ryan Ox, the catcher. Third base is Ross. McGann at short. There's a Slider in there for strike one. Reeves at second and Goki over at first. Left field is Laffrey, center field Burke, and right field Fernandez. The 0-1 curveball is outside, 1-1. That slider's outside, 2-1. It's been a while since we've had a game here at Varnado Stadium. The Nighthawks have been on the road for the last couple of weeks. There's a curveball way outside, 3-1. March 30th was the last home game against Blue Mountain College. The Nighthawks traveled to Montgomery to play Faulkner in three games. There's a foul ball out of play to the right side to Kaysen Bowie. Then we traveled for a midweek game against Middle Georgia State after the Faulkner series. Then we went to Pulaski, Tennessee to play UT Southern. Kaysen Bowie leads off for the Nighthawks with a base on balls, and he'll be at first base for Mike Sowers. Just coming back from the road trip to Tennessee and have a couple of games tonight against Trinity Baptist, and we play our final regular season games this weekend against University of Mobile Conference, our final conference series of the season as well. First pitch to Sowers is in there for a strike one. Bowie perfect 9-for-9 on stolen bases this season, and he's chase back to first base by Andrew Moeller. Mike Sowers, the batter, is leading the team in stolen bases with 10. So if Bowie can get a pitcher run on here, he can equal that number. And Sowers is going to hit that ball into center field. Burke is over, and he'll make the grab for the first out.
Now batting Max Pickard.
Pickard stands in for the Nighthawks. Nighthawks even on the season at 22 wins, 22 losses, trying to get back above the 500 mark as they've been all season. Air ball's hit hard in the right field. Back goes Fernandez to the wall, and that ball is off the fence in right field. Bowie is taking a turn around third, but he'll stay there. So it'll be a stand-up double for Max Pickard. And now with one out, the Nighthawks are threatening here in the first inning. And that'll bring up Gene Checo, the DH for the Nighthawks. With a good opportunity for a couple of RBIs. He has 6 on the season. Limited action, 33 at-bats this season. And a good chance here to plate the game's first run or two. First pitch is hit hard but foul as the Eagles' first baseman Goki's playing in front of the bag. Now he kind of walks back a few steps. And Ross is also even a little bit in front of the bag at third, so they'll try to cut off a run if a ground ball's hit to one of the corners. Up the middle, they're playing normal depth. They're willing to concede a run on a ground ball up the middle. That curveball is outside. Good pitch by Moeller, but it stayed outside. JT Watley is on deck. And the 1-1 is in the dirt, 2-1. 2-1 is hit on the ground to second. That will plate the run. Reeves fields it and throws over to first. So credit Checo with an RBI on a ground out 4-3. And that'll bring up JT Wadley. Picker was able to move over to third on the play. So now Wadley bats in a 1-0 ball game.
That ball gets by the catcher.
Gets by the catcher. Here comes Picker to score the second run. So wild pitch plates Max Pickard, and the Nighthawks grab a early 2-0 lead. Now the bases are cleared for JT Wadley. Nighthawks and Trinity Baptist play back on February 6th, a doubleheader over in Jacksonville, and that both games were won by Thomas. Pretty comfortably, in fact. And after a tough couple of road trip weekends, they could use a win here. Nice play there by Ross over third. He's not going to be able to retire Wadley. He'll get an infield single. So ground ball between short and third. Diving catch by Ross. Great play. But no chance to get Wadley. He was down the line. Now there'll be a runner at first base, but there are two outs for Easton Willis. Curveball to Willis is low ball one. Two balls, no strikes. Gabe Tufelski on deck for the Nighthawks. Already up 2-0. As we're just getting started in with game one of a doubleheader. That ball's hit in the air to the left side, and that's going to get out of play. 2-1 now. There's a fastball in the inside corner called strike two. Willis hits that out in the air to center field. Burke is under it, and he's going to make the catch to retire the Nighthawks. But the Nighthawks score a couple of runs on two hits. No errors, one left. We played one complete here at Barnardo Stadium. Your score, Thomas University 2, Trinity Baptist College 0. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Two nothing, so we head to the second inning. Peacock will be pitching to the 5-6-7 hitters for the Eagles. Parker Laffrey, Seth Reeves, and Zachary Ross. Now he's pitching with a 2-0 lead. First pitch to Laffrey is in there for strike one. That fastball misses high, ball one. So for Laffrey, he's batting 256 on the season, does lead the Eagles in runs scored, tied with Seth Reeves, 15 runs scored on the season. As there's a called strike two. Also leads in stolen bases with seven. Leads the team in stolen bases with seven. That pitch is way outside, 2-2. Two-two outside, full count now. Laffrey, the senior from Winter Springs, Florida, and that on the inside corner called strike three. Good pitch by Brad Peacock, and just on the inside corner. For the second strikeout of the game. And that'll bring up Seth Reeves, second baseman for the Eagles. And it's the first pitch out in the air to left field. Pickard is under it, and he'll make the easy catch for out number two. Zachary Ross, the third baseman, stands in. Nobody on and two outs. Darren Gokey for the Eagles. The first baseman is on deck, and that pitch is swung on and missed. One ball, one strike. This is a Corey Rice batting, or Ross batting 333 on the season, but very limited action. Actually, he's only has three official at bats on the season, one hit. So there's your 333 batting average. Has walked three times, so he's had a few more plate appearances. He faces a one ball, two strikes, and he hits that in the air to right field. Watley going out and Bowie coming in. It'll be Bowie to make the catch to retire the side. So Peacock gets him in order here in the top of the second. We played 1.5. Your score, Thomas University 2, Trinity Baptist College 0. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Bottom of the second. We go, and it'll be 7-8-9 for Thomas, Gabe Tofelsky, Turner Maddox, and Cameron Rosario.
Now
facing the right-hander Andrew Moeller for TBC. TBC 17-19 on the season. And the Nighthawks 22-22. There's a pitch that misses way outside, and I'll have to put a new baseball in play here. One ball, no strikes. Gabe Tofelsky, the sophomore outfielder from Brooksville, Florida, and hits that on the ground. Going to be a tough play for Ross. He fields it, makes the long throw, not in time to get Tofelsky. So a second time, an infield hit to the left side on both. Ross is able to make the play, the difficult play in both cases, but no chance to make the throw in either. So two of the three hits for the Nighthawks have been infield hits to the third baseman, the other hit being a double to the right center field gap by Max Pickard. So another good start for the Nighthawks here in the second. With Turner Maddox batting and Gabe Tofelsky down at first. That pitch is a little bit outside, 2-0. We'll see how Coach Fleenor handles this. Tofelsky's been pretty active on the season in stolen base attempts with 11 attempts, 9 successful. There's a pitch in there for a strike. Tofelsky's been on as a courtesy runner before at times this season, and also with his own doing, and just like he did there with an infield hit. There's a nice pitch by Moeller for strike two. So two balls, two strikes to Turner Maddox. There goes a runner. That's outside. The throw down is going to not be in time. Stolen base number 10 on the season for Gabe Tofelsky, and that'll tie Mike Sowers for the team lead in that category. Three balls, two strikes to Maddox. Cameron Rosario on deck, and we're going to have a timeout called at the plate here. The payoff pitch is inside, ball four, so runners now first and second with nobody out. Bottom of the second inning, Cameron Rosario will bat, and then we'll be back to the top of the order in Kaysen Bowie. Rosario, a sophomore out of Jacksonville, Florida Atlantic High School. We'll see if Coach Fleenor has him bunting here with first and second, nobody out. And he is, and he lays down a foul ball. So that'll be no balls and one strike. Like some activity in the TBC bullpen. I'll see if I can get a number on the reliever down there, just loosening up here as there's Nighthawks have already scored two, and we have first and second, nobody out here. As Rosario lays down that bunt, that's going to be a successful sack as the throw goes over to first in time to retire Rosario. So a 5-3 put out, but give Rosario credit for a bunt, a sacrifice bunt. Now they're runners at second and third with one out. So the infield comes in for the Eagles, and the slider is just a little bit outside ball one. Bowie batting 356 on the season. That includes his first at-bat in this game, which was a walk. Leads the team in hits at 47. That ball's hit in the air to the left center field gap. That's going to be in there for extra bases for Bowie. Center fielder Burke cuts it off, but two runs are going to score. And Bowie is at second base with a stand-up double. So a nice rip there by Kaysen Bowie. 48th hit of the season, and RBI is 34 and 35. And now the Nighthawks lead 4-0. So Mike Sowers, will be the hitter and I'll be the hitter and I. Between Bowie,
the first pitch to Sowers
in there for a strike. And Sowers are kind of, and also Max Pickard are battling it out at the top for the team leading batting average. Coming into the game, Sowers led 359. Bowie was 356. And there's a ball that's hit on the ground to short. It's fielded and throw was made in time to retire Sowers, but on the play, Bowie is able to move over to third.
And now batting number 14, Max Pickard.
And Max Pickard was 352, and he'll bat now. So a three-way race here as we head to the final five games of the regular season. We're all hopeful that we'll have some postseason games, but that's, we'll talk about that a little later. It's going to take some wins this weekend and some help probably. There's a ball outside, ball one to Pickard. So Sowers was 359 coming in, but he's 0 for 2 in this game. Bowie is 1 for 1, and Pickard is also 1 for 1, both with gappers, doubles in the gap. And there's a pitch that looked pretty good from Moeller, called a ball. So it's two balls and no strikes with the potential fifth run at third base. It's Kaysen Bowie. And that slider also misses. So Moeller not missing by much with these last couple of pitches, but ruled balls. And Pickard's way ahead in the count. Three balls, no strikes with Gene Checo on deck. There's the 3-0, and that's going to be a little bit high. And Moeller's looking into the umpire to wondering where those last three pitches missed. And we're going to have a visit from the TVC coach, or one of the assistant coaches, to come out and talk to Andrew Moeller as he's issued a walk to Max Pickard, though. I will say a couple of those look pretty good. And it looks like they've already made a call to the bullpen. So we'll step away and check on the new pitcher in just a moment. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Brandon Hoeing is going to be the new pitcher for TBC. right-handed sophomore from Panama City, Florida, out of Bozeman High School. And he'll relieve Andrew Moeller, who is responsible for the runners at first and third. So for Hoang, it'll just be his eighth appearance of the season, 13 and a third innings pitched with a 6.75 ERA and a whip of 2.02. Eight strikeouts in his 13 innings. So runners at first and third are responsibility of the starting pitcher, Andrew Moeller. But there are two outs here in the bottom of the second inning. The first pitch to Checo is hit hard in the left field. That's going to reach the bullpen for Trinity Baptist, strike one. Checo grounded out to second in his first at bat. From Citizens Christian Academy in Samana, Dominican Republic, is Checo. Is that slider? And here's a delayed steal by Pickard, and he's going to stand up at second base. So now there's runners at second and third, but there are two strikes on Checo. And the swing and a miss by Checo. So Hoang comes in and strikes out Gene Checo to retire the side. But the Nighthawks do score two runs on two hits. No errors, two runners left on base. We play two complete. Your score, Thomas University 4, TBC 0. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Top of the third inning, game one of a two-game doubleheader here at Varnado Stadium. It's a beautiful night for baseball if you're in the area and don't have plans after work. Come on by the ballpark. There'll be plenty of baseball left to play. And the Nighthawks looking good in game one, 4-0 as we go to the third inning. Peacock will pitch to the 8-9-1 hitters for the Eagles. First baseman Goki, and then it'll be Logan McGann. And back to the top of the order, Jacob Burke. And quickly, Peacock is ahead, no balls, two strikes. Fastball's way up high. 1-1-2 now to Goki's limited action this season. Only played in 11 of the games for the Eagles. Only a couple of official at bats. He's even now, two balls and two strikes. Fastball's outside. Full count now. Swing and a miss. Peacock gets to strike out. And now it's Logan McGann, the shortstop, will bat. Trinity Baptist weekend will be the final weekend of regular season play for Thomas University, but looking at Trinity Baptist's schedule here, as that ball's hit out into right field, and Bowie doesn't have to move, catches that ball for out number two. And Jacob Burke will bat with two outs and nobody on. So Trinity Baptist plays this weekend over in Orange Park, Florida. Then they'll have a couple of games next Monday, and then another weekend series. Swing and a miss by Burke. Actually, a four-game series against Toccoa Falls before they begin postseason play in the NCCAA South Region. There's a ball hit into foul territory, and it's no balls, two strikes to Jacob Burke, who led the game off. First pitch of the game, hit a sharp single, and that's the only hit through the lineup for Trinity Baptist, and that's fouled back, stays at no balls, two strikes. And in fact, the only base runner for Trinity Baptist to this point. The 0-2 is misses high, one ball, two strikes. There's a slow call, strike three. That looked a little inside. Peacock got the benefit of the call, and that'll retire side. So the Eagles go down 1-2-3 here in the top of the third. We go to the bottom half with your score, Thomas 4, TBC 0. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Brandon Hoeing goes back out there for the Eagles in the bottom half of the third inning. And he'll face the 5-6-7 hitters for the Nighthawks, JT Wadley, Easton Willis, and Gabe Tefelski. The Nighthawks leading 4-0. Game one of a doubleheader. Ooh, and the first pitch hits Wadley, and he'll go down to first base. And so for the third inning, third straight inning, I should say, the leadoff man is aboard for the Nighthawks. And that's a good streak to have. In fact, all the first two innings, those runs have scored. Casey Bowie walked to lead off the first. He scored the game's first run. And then Tefelski hit an infield single to lead off the second inning, and he scored. And we'll see what happens to JT Wadley as he was hit by a pitch, the first pitch of the third inning. And he's at first base for Easton Willis. And Willis hits that into left field. Lafferty's under it, and he'll make the grab. And Wadley will have to retreat back to first base. And now Gabe Tefelski. Go back, looking at Wadley's only attempt at two stolen bases this season, one out of two. First pitch is in there for strike one to Gabe Tefelski. He's batting 288 on the season, 80 official at-bats. Four home runs on the season. There's a nice pitch by Huang. Strike two. His 23rd start for Tefelski, 38th game appearance. And hits that one in the air in right center field.
Fernandez
calling off Burke, and Fernandez makes the catch. So after Wadley is hit by a pitch, the next two batters fly out. And it'll be up to Turner Maddox to see if the Nighthawks can continue their streak of scoring the leadoff base runner. First pitch to Maddox, misses high. Cam Rosario will be the on-deck hitter if Turner Maddox can reach. The 2-0 is on the outside corner, strike one. There's a throw over the first base, but Wadley is back safely. Maddox fouls that off to the left side. Two balls, two strikes is the count. Four runs, four hits, no errors for the Nighthawks. No runs, a single hit for TBC, no errors. As we're in the bottom of the third in a seven-inning game one of a doubleheader. And that's just a little bit outside, full count now. There goes Wadley, and it's pitch misses inside, ball four. So it'll be first and second for Cameron Rosario. Ball, no strikes to Rosario. Two outs. Nighthawks trying to come up with a two-out rally to extend their lead, currently at 4-0, and the Rosario lays off that, but it's called strike one. That ball's nubbed toward the second baseman, Reeves, who will make the easy catch for out number three. So the Nighthawks get a couple of base runners here in the bottom of the third, but score no runs. We go to the fourth. Your score, Thomas University 4, Trinity Baptist College 0. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Top of the fourth inning here at Varnado Stadium, and Brad Peacock is back out there for the Nighthawks. The only hit allowed by Peacock and the only base runner for the Eagles came on the game's first pitch. Sharp single by leadoff man Jacob Burke, and after that, Peacock has retired 9 in a row, including 4 by strikeout. Okay. And he'll face the 2-3-4 hitters here in the top of the fourth inning. Ryan Ongst, Gavin Williams, and Jordan Fernandez. The first pitch is in there for strike one to Hawks. So Nighthawks are trying to find a way this weekend to work their way into the conference tournament, which begins in a couple weeks. Nice pitch by Peacock on the outside corner. And so it gets a left-handed batter. Our home plate umpire has been generous with that outside corner, and Peacock has taken advantage a few times here. And he tries it again, but this one's hit to him on a ground ball, but an easy play to first base for Peacock, and that's the first out here in the fourth inning. So three teams in the conference don't make the tournament, 8 do. And so the Nighthawks are in the battle for one of those 8 spots. There's a fastball on the outside corner, strike one, and things got a little more difficult after this weekend when we dropped 2 out of 3 to Tennessee Southern, who now is in front of us. There's a swing and a miss, strike two. So there's 4 teams with either 9 or 10 wins on the season, Thomas University being one of those 4. Two of those teams are going to make the tournament 1-1. There's a Sowers makes a nice play, but he's not going to be able to throw out the base runner. So the second hit of the game, this one by Gavin Williams on an infield single up the middle. And so with one out, there's Jordan Fernandez bats. So Stillman College is at the bottom of the standings, 5-22, so they're not going to make the playoffs. And then the 4 teams that have a chance for two slots are UT Southern, Blue Mountain Christian, Bruton Parker, and Thomas University. There's a swing and a miss. Out of those four, Thomas has played the most games, 27, and won 10. UT Southern has also won 10, but they've only played 24 games. There's a move to first. Both Blue Mountain Christian and Bruton Parker are 9-15, so they're one game behind in the win column, but like UT Southern, have played three fewer games. There's a foul ball back and out of play. Two strikes to count to Fernandez. Thomas has University of Mobile coming in this weekend for three games, final three conference games. So we need to add to that 10-win total and then maybe get some help from the remaining opponents of UT Southern, Blue Mountain Christian, and Bruton Parker. University of Mobile is 14-10. Only 16-15 overall, so they're beatable. There's a throw, nice play by Watley to make the catch. Got a left-hander warming up in the bullpen for TBC. Try to get there. Goes the runner, and that ball's hit on the ground on a hit and run. That's going to be a tough play for Willis. Fields it and makes the long throw to get the runner. And for out number two. So 5-3 put out retires Fernandez, and that was a high chopper. And Willis knew he was going to have to make a strong throw when the ball finally came down, which he did, and got Fernandez by a step or two. Williams will be down at second base for Parker Laffrey. And Laffrey hits that ball into right center field. Long run for Tefelski, but he's able to get there and make the grab. So the Eagles will strand another runner at second base. We've played 3.5. Your score remains Thomas 4, Trinity Baptist 0. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Brandon Hoeing back out there for TBC, and he'll face the top of the order for Thomas, Bowie, Sowers, and Pickard. As the lefty that was throwing in the bullpen for TBC is now trotting back to the dugout. Casey Bowie is 1-for-1 with the walk and run scored in the first and then doubled in the second. And that pitch is outside to start him off. So Nighthawks have put their leadoff man on in all three innings so far, scoring that runner twice. failing to in the last inning. There's a foul ball, didn't mean to, hit by Kaysen Bowie. So Bowie's double back in the second inning collected two RBIs. Tefelski and Maddox scored on the gapper. There's a pitch that catches the outside corner. One ball, two strikes. One, two, curveball, swing and a miss. Bowie goes down swinging on a good pitch by Brandon Hoeing.
Number 23, Mike Sowers.
Nighthawks have collected four hits and drawn four walks and one hit by pitch in this game, so nine. The Nighthawks have reached base in three innings. There's a little soft liner caught by McGann at shortstop, and on one pitch, Sowers is retired.
Now batting number 14, Max Pickard.
And that'll bring up Pickard. Pickard, like Bowie, reached in both of the first two innings. He hit a double in the first inning. And then drew a walk in the second inning. The 1-0 is swung on and fouled back to the screen. 1-1 now. And now the lefty's back up in the bullpen, so he may just come back to the dugout to grab something. That ball's hit out of play. 1-2 now.
Wait up our waist for some new baseballs.
Let's see if I can get a number. 26 is warming up. One ball, two strikes to Pickard, and he hits that into the bullpen where Joseph Labas, the senior left-handed pitcher from, well, it's on the roster, it has him as a right-hander, but I can see him throwing his left-hander from Orange Park, Florida. As Pickard hits that into left field, that's going to drop in for a single. So Pickard all three times has been on base, two hits and a walk. And he'll be there for Gene Checo. Pickard stole his 10th base of the season earlier in this game, so he now shares the lead in stolen base with Mike Sowers and also Gabe Tefelski, who has a stolen base in this game. And we're going to have a visit to the mound by one of the assistant coach for TBC, and they're going to make a move to the bullpen. So we'll check on the new pitcher. We'll step aside for 90 seconds. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Joseph Labas enters the game for Trinity Baptist. I believe it's Labas, L-A-B-A-S. Pitcher, first baseman, senior from Orange Park, Florida, out of Trinity Christian Academy. Labas making his fifth appearance of the season. 7 1/3 innings pitched. The 2.05 whip and an 8.59 ERA is 10 strikeouts in his 7.1 innings. And he'll relieve Brandon Hoying here in the bottom of the fourth inning. It's 4-0 lead for the Nighthawks. We have a runner at first, two outs, and Gene Checo is due up after Max Pickard delivered a single, a two-out single. And he is now 2-for-3 on the game and pushing hard to be the team leader in batting average as we go to the final weekend series, as he was, Pickard was 352 coming into this game. And it's 2-for-2 with a walk. So we'll see how that shakes out. Checo. There goes a delayed steal by Pickard. The throw is down, and he's going to be out. So the Nighthawks try a delayed steal, but TBC had done their homework, and they were ready for that, and now we'll retire the side. So no runs on a hit, no errors, nobody left. We've played four complete with your score, Thomas 4, Trinity Christian 0. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. So Ryan Ox for Trinity Baptist College is able to gun down Max Pickard for the third out of the fourth inning. Only the second time all season Pickard's been caught stealing, as it was a trademark Tom Fleener delayed steal that nearly worked, but a good throw by Ox to retire Pickard, and so we hit to the fifth. It'll be Seth Reeves, Zachary Ross, and Darren Goki for Trinity Baptist. The first pitch to Reeves is outside, ball one. So Peacock's still on the mound for the Nighthawks. He's throwing to Cam Rosario, the catcher. One of inside. Easton Willis at third. Mike Sowers at short. Turner Maddox at second, and JT Wiley at first. In the outfield is Max Pickard in left, Gabe Tofelsky in center, and Kaysen Bowie in right field. And I don't know where that pitch missed. I guess a little high, 3-0 now. And there's a pitch on the outside corner, strike one. There's a fastball on the corner again. Three balls and two strikes now. And that is a little bit high, ball four. So leadoff walk for Reeves, and that'll bring up Zachary Ross, the third baseman. Zachary Ross batting 333, but again, not limited action. Limited plate appearances, I should say. There's a good pitch by Bragg Peacock, strike one. And Ross flew out to right field his first time. That ball's hit hard to left. Pickard's coming in, and he's going to make the catch. So well hit by Ross, but he'll be retired for the first out of the inning. That'll bring up Darren Goeke. First pitch to Goeke is hit on the ground towards second. Maddox up with it, flips around, throws to shortstop Sowers. And that'll be the only out that the Nighthawks can get. But a nice play by Maddox to get to that ball. And now there are two outs. And Goeke will be at first base on the fielder's choice. And the batter's Logan McGann, the shortstop. McGann hits that hard in the gap. That's going to drop in there around second, and holding is Goeke. He was looked like he was going to make the turn and try to take third, but the ball was cut off there by the Nighthawks, and so he had to put on the brakes and get back to second base. And he'll be there with after the single by McGann. So runners at first and second, two outs though. And we're back to the top of the order, Jacob Burke. Who has one of the three hits by the Eagles in this game, and he takes a close look at that one. The slider that goes down and outside, 1-0. Burke led off the game with a sharp single. And then Peacock retired the next 10 batters in a row. There's another sharp single to left field. We'll see if they send Goeke. They're gonna send him. They should be able to get him. And the ball's unable to be handled by Willis. And that's going to score the first run for TBC. So the throw came in from Pickard, which is a tough one to handle from Willis. And so that's going to allow the run to score. So Burke gets an RBI single. Goeke comes around to score. McGann holds up at second. The score is now 4-1. And first pitch to Ryan Ox is outside, ball one. So the fourth hit of the game with the Eagles, two of them by leadoff man Jacob Burke. And this one with two outs drives in the first run for Trinity Baptist. And now Peacock's behind 2-0 with Gavin Williams on deck, who has one of the two other hits not by Burke. Some Nighthawks down there just stretching and loosening up. Nobody warming up just yet as that ball is way inside, and that's going to be a four-pitch walk. Nice play by Rosario to keep it from going to the backstop, but I guess it didn't matter, and I guess I must have lost track of the count as it's three ball. It must have been a three-ball count. Now it's 3-0, so it's a little premature. It's not a four-pitch walk just yet. And there's a good pitch for a called strike one. There's a move to first and safe, close play at first base. But Berg was able to get back in, though he did not slide getting back in. So a little sneaky play by the Nighthawks almost worked. The 3-1 to Hawks. He hits that ball in the air to left field. Long run for Pickert. It's going to be in foul territory and over the fence. So it's 3 balls, 2 strikes. So the runners will get a head start here. Full count, 2 outs. Let's see if the Peacock tries another pickoff move to see if they might be leaving too early. He does, but no dice. So we'll have the payoff pitch to Ryan Ox, who made caught stealing to end the fourth inning and has a chance to help his team out here in the fifth. And that pitch just misses a little bit inside. Good pitch by Peacock, but Ox doesn't go for it. And now their base is loaded. We'll have a courtesy runner for the catcher, Angst. This is going to be number 33. That's Dominic Gattinella will be the courtesy runner. And we'll have a visit from Coach Gonzalez before we see the first pitch to Gavin Williams. Nobody warming up that I can see for Thomas University, so this is just Coach Gonzalez trying to talk him through to get out of this inning and see if we can move. And there must have been somebody warming up that I couldn't see because they are going to make a call to the bullpen. So we're going to step away for 90 seconds. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Jacob Pino comes in for the Nighthawks, and he'll try to close things out here in the top of the fifth. This thing's just getting interesting. Nighthawks are cruising out in the lead 4-0, but with 2 outs here in the fifth inning, Trinity Baptist has got things going here, including a run that's already scored, and bases are loaded. Had a walk to lead off the inning. Peacock was pitching, walked Reeves. Then a hard hit ball to the left that Pickert caught. Then there was a fielder's choice, so there were 2 outs and just a runner at first. But then we had a single by McGann, another single by Burke, and then here a walk by Ongst. And so it's a 4-1 game, bases loaded in the top of the fifth. And Pino will come in. Pitch to the seventh batter of this inning, Gavin Williams. Pino, this will be his 17th appearance of the season for Pino. There's a good fastball in the outside corner, strike one. 17 appearances, four starts for Pino. 32 innings pitched, 34 strikeouts in those 32 innings. Opponents batting 336. Against a right-handed pitcher, and he's nice play by Rosario. Had to go way outside and snag that ball. Pino, the sophomore out of Apopka, Florida. And he could thank his buddy Cameron Rosario for saving a run on that pitch because it was fastball way outside. The 1-1 is a slider, and that's just popped up on the infield. That should do it. Turner Maddox under it, and he'll make the grab. So the Eagles score a run and leave three stranded. We play four and a half with your score, Thomas University 4, Trinity Baptist College 1. You watch a Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. So 4-1 game now as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Joseph Labas back out there for Trinity Baptist as he was pitching when Ryan Augst threw out Max Pickert. And batting was Gene Checo, so he'll start things off here as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. We're in the bottom of the fifth, a seven-inning game. Eagles will have two more at-bats. There's a curveball in there for a strike. And Jacob Pino now in relief for Brad Peacock as Checo fouls that one off. Close the book on Peacock. 4 2/3 innings pitched. One run allowed, it was earned. That pitch is outside. The ball and two strikes. Four strikeouts for Peacock in his 4 2/3 innings pitched. Full count now to Gene Checo, leading off the bottom of the fourth for the Nighthawks. And Checo hits that into center field. Burke is under it, and he'll make the catch for the out number one. And that'll be JT Watley. So Peacock just see one earned run. Only four hits and a walk, or two walks. And then Pino came in and got out of the jam. The bases loaded. Peacock was really cruising along until the top of the fifth. Got into a jam, and Pino came in and got him out of it. And there's a swing and a miss by Watley. So only the one earned run in 4 2/3 innings for Peacock. Not a bad. Actually, a pretty good outing for him. 1-1 to Whiteley is hit hard in the center. Back goes Burke, and that's going to be over his head all the way to the fence. Whiteley is rounding second. He's going to try for a triple here. The throw is coming in. There's a throw to third, and that's off the mark. So a stand-up triple for JT Whiteley. As he hit that one straight up the middle of the center field over the head of Burke, who was playing a little bit in on Whiteley and had a long run to go retrieve that ball. By the time he could get there and get the ball in, Whiteley was standing at third base. So he's there with Easton Willis, one out here in the bottom of the fifth, and that pitch looked pretty good. Called a ball to Willis, who has an RBI chance here, one out and runner at third. Infield is in for the Eagles. They're going to try to cut off that run. But LaBosse has thrown two straight balls to Easton Willis. The 2-0 is outside, and now it's 3-0. Gabe Tefelski bats next. Easton Willis is 0-2. Tefelski 1-2, and there's a walk to Easton Willis on four pitches, and we'll see how the Eagles defense sets up now with the runner at first and third. Gabe Tefelski, so they'll keep the first baseman and third baseman in. Actually, in fact, the first baseman has to be in because he's holding on the base runner there. Third baseman Ross is on the edge of the grass, and up the middle they'll play for the double play. Don't see any action right now in Trinity Baptist bullpen, nor do I see it in Thomas, although I didn't see any a minute ago for Thomas, and I was blocked by the big bench there because Pino was warming up and he came in relief. There's a couple players down there stretching, but no one that I can see throwing for either team. There's a big curveball, misses high. 1-1 to Tefelski. So Nighthawks are trying to respond to the run posted by TBC in the top of the fifth. And Tefelski swings at that and fouls it off. And so now he's 1-2, just needs to get something in play here and hopefully score JT Whiteley from third, who had a triple to center field just a moment ago. That's inside, 2-2. Turner Maddox waits on deck, who's batted twice and walked both times. As that ball's hit hard in the left, that's going to be a single. JT Whiteley, they're going to try to force Willis at second. The ball is hit so hard, they actually had an opportunity for that, but Easton Willis is able to get to second safely. So an RBI single for Gabe Tefelski. And now we got the four-run cushion again. It's 5-1 now. Turner Maddox bats. Runners at first and second, still only one out. And the fastball's outside, ball one. There's a called strike, 1-1 now. So after Checo flied out to center, Whiteley hit a triple over the head of the center fielder. And Willis was walked. Tefelski on a 2-2 count drills one to left field. There's a good curveball by LaBosse, strike two. Tefelski hits the RBI single to left field and out the ball and two strikes to Turner Maddox. And Maddox hits that in the center field, left center field, I should say, because Laffrey, the left fielder, comes over and makes the catch for out number two.
Now batting number one, Cameron Rosario.
And so there are two outs, runners still at first and second. Cameron Rosario bats. Rosario was 0 for 1 with a sack bunt. In this game, 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors for Thomas. 1-4-0 for Trinity Baptist as the fastball's too far inside, ball one. Kason Bowie would bat next should Rosario reach base here. And there's a ball that goes all the way to the backstop. And the wild pitch advances both runners. And there's a 2-0 count as there is activity now. And the TBC is, I think they may have been crossed up on that pitch because Ryan Ox is out to talk to his pitcher. It looks like number 33 is the right-handed pitcher in the Eagles bullpen, just starting to warm up now. So that's Dominic Gattinella is the potential next pitcher for TBC. Is that curveball's in there for strike one? Swung on a miss, 2 balls and 2 strikes now. So 5-1 game, Trinity's trying to keep things within striking distance, and a big hit here from Rosario would kind of push it that much farther away. So big pitch coming up here, 2 balls, 2 strikes. There is a base open. As Rosario hits that hard into right field, but it's going to be foul. Count remains 2-2. It's a good idea by Rosario on an outside pitch to go to the opposite field, but it was too far foul. And I'm guessing there's no gate that can be opened by the bullpen down there because none of the Nighthawks sitting on that big bench made an effort to get the ball, and somebody had to come running out of the dugout all the way down there to get it. 2-2, and that's way up and out. Full count now.
Sorry, it's that one.
It's down to the right side now. That's kind of play this time. Looks like Carson Thomas, number 42, went and retrieved that foul ball to Rosario. There's another foul ball to the right side. So now I see somebody from the bullpen from Thomas going to get that one, so they're willing to do a little bit of help. Shagging these foul balls as Rosario keeps hitting them off to the right side. The 3-2 is hit in the air to center field. Burke backs up a couple steps, now has to come in, and he'll make the grab to retire the side. But the Nighthawks get their run back. We play 5, your score, Thomas University 5, Trinity Baptist College 1. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. We go to the sixth. The Nighthawks leading 5-1. Jacob Pino back out there. And he'll face Jordan Fernandez, Parker Laffrey, and Seth Reeves for TBC as we're waiting on Cameron Rosario, who made the last out of the bottom of the fifth. And it looks like we do have a new second baseman for the Nighthawks. It's going to be Jeremy Santiago, number 55, coming in for Maddox. Rosario still the catcher. Easton Willis still over at third. Mike Sowers at short, and JT Wiley at first. Max Pickard in left, Gabe Tefelski in center, and Kason Bowie in right. As the throw goes down to the new second baseman, Jeremy Santiago, and we'll get things going here in the top of the sixth. First pitch is outside to Fernandez. And so is the second pitch. 2-0 now. Air ball's hit on the ground to Mike Sowers. Tough hop for Sowers. Makes the play and throws to first, but not. It's going to get past Wadley. Nice backup by Cam Rosario to hold up the runner there. So tough hop for Sowers, but it's going to look like it's going to go down as an error as he threw the ball wildly to Watley. And Fernandez will be at first base on the E6. So he a hard ground ball that kind of ate up Mike Sowers a little bit. Picked it off the ground and still had a chance to get the runner. I think he threw it too quickly and too hard, and it short-hopped him. There's a close play at first on a pickoff attempt. Wally wasn't able to pick it for him, and so we have the leadoff man on for Trinity Baptist on the game's first error. There's a fastball in there for strike to Parker Laffrey. He's 0-2. That ball's hit. Oh, nice play by Pino. He's going to get a double play. Great reaction by Jacob Pino there on a line drive right back at him, and he had to go down right at the mound to catch that, to pick it off the ground. And so no chance for Fernandez. He thought he was going to need to hustle down a second to try to break up the double play, or maybe it could have got through the hole for a single, but Pino was able to go down and grab it before it hit the ground and easily turned the double play. And the first pitch now to Reeves is a called strike one. There's a ball hit into left. That's going to drop in there for a single, and that's Seth Reeves who hits that single to left field. Zachary Ross will bat, so now that play by Pino looks even bigger. If that he doesn't go down and snag that ball, it's probably possibly up the middle for a base hit. And it would have been first and second, nobody out. And then that hit probably drives home at least one run there. But Pino made a nice grab and easily turned the double play. There's a called strike two to Ross, who's 0-2. Hit the ball hard last inning, but Tefelski made the play. Pickard in left field made the play. the 0-2 way outside. There's a fake snap throw by Rosario. Good idea to hold on to it. The 1-2 swung on a miss, strike three. And so the Eagles get a runner on, but leave them stranded. We've played 5.5 with a score, Thomas 5, TBC 1. You're watching Nighthawks Baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. New pitcher for Trinity Baptist College is number 33, Dominic Gattinella from Brooksville, Florida, Nature Coast High School, a freshman making an appearance here. Trying to hold the Nighthawks at 5 runs as we're in the bottom of the 6th inning. And Thomas hoping this will be their last plate appearance for game one. We'll play 7 more innings right after this. So for Gattinella, limited action. This is only the 2nd appearance of the season. Pitched 1 complete inning, allowed 3 earned runs, had 1 strikeout. And so getting an opportunity here for some work towards the end of the season for Trinity Baptist is Gattinella. He's a freshman. Pitcher listed as a pitcher outfielder. And he'll be facing the top of the Nighthawks batting order. Kaysen Bowie, Mike Sowers, and Max Pickard. Bowie 1-for-2 in this game with a walk. Had a 2 RBI double back in the 2nd inning. First pitch to Bowie is low, ball 1. Lots of activity going on in the Southern States Athletic Conference. No conference games, of course, but a lot of out-of-conference games tonight as that pitch is outside. 2-0. UT Southern, the team we just played in Tennessee, lost 2 out of 3 to UT Southern. There's a 3rd straight pitch that misses low and away. UT Southern traveled to Lindsey Wilson, Columbia, Kentucky. As that fastball is in there for a strike. 3 balls and 1 strike. Russ College is visiting Stillman College in Tuscaloosa. this afternoon. That game's probably final by now. We'll check it. 3-1 to Bowie is just a little bit outside, and Bowie will walk
now batting
to lead off the bottom of the sixth. And we'll have a pinch hitter for the Nighthawks. Riley Borgert will bat for Mike Sowers, the shortstop. And so Borgert, who's been injured for the last couple of weekends, I believe. I think he was injured in the last home game, which was back in late March, end of March. So he's been on the IR a little bit. And his sophomore from Madison, he takes the first pitch for a strike. One ball, one strike to Riley Borgert, who's having a pretty good season until his injury, batting 369. Doesn't have the official at-bats to be the team leader officially, but he does have the best batting average on the team coming into this game at 369 and 65 plate official plate appearances. There's a couple of home runs and 10 RBIs. And Coach Fleener's going to let him hit away instead of trying any kind of sacrifice. And he just drills that one into left field, but foul. So 2-2 to Riley Borgert. And we'll see if Riley starts the second game at shortstop as Coach Fleener's will typically shuffle things around from game one to game two in a midweek doubleheader. But Borger getting a chance for a plate appearance here in game one with nobody out and runner at first base. And he hits that one to the left side of, and ooh, that was closer than I thought. It was a foul ball, but not by much. The full count still to Riley Borgert. Bowie at first base, not looking to steal, I don't think, and that pitch is way outside, ball four. So a couple of walks allowed by Dominic Gattinella. And it does look like Sowers is going to come back in the game. Borgert, so whatever was ailing Borgert must have been enough still
that he
got a good idea for him to run the bases. So we're going to put Mike Sowers back in the game to run for Riley Borgert. And we're going to have, there's a mound visit by the first baseman and the catcher, and it looks like some activity is brewing in TBC number 32. Jeffrey Vivian, the freshman, listed as a second baseman on the roster, is actually the right-handed pitcher warming up for TBC. Max Pickert will bat with runners at first and second, nobody out, and he's having a pretty good day. I don't expect a bunt here either from Max Pickert, who's 2-for-2 with a walk. I think he'll get the green light to hit. We'll see if I'm right or wrong. And I'll look to be right, but there's a curveball high, ball one. The 1-0 is just popped straight up. The catcher hesitated and is not able to get back there fast enough to catch it. Don't think Ryan Ox realized that foul ball was going to stay in play as he froze there behind the plate and then his pitcher was alerting him that he could go back there and catch it, and he didn't have enough time at that point. One ball, one strike. As Pickard hits that to the left side, and that's going to be foul. Lafferty is over there, and he goes ahead and picks it up and throws it back in. And now the count's a ball and two strikes. So it'll be Pickard, then Gene Checo is in the on-deck circle. And then JT Wadley after Checo, assuming there's no pinch hitters. As Pickard hits that into center field, coming in is Burke, going out is the second baseman Reeves, and it's going to be Reeves who makes the play to retire Pickard.
Now batting,
so Checo will bat now. There's one out. 5-1 Nighthawks lead. We're batting in the bottom of the sixth of a seven-inning game. So the Eagles are down to their final three outs when they retire the Nighthawks. There's a foul ball out of play for Checo. Stillman College did win their game against Rust today, 8-4. As we check a few of the Southern States scores. Faulkner was playing Alabama A&M University, and they're they lost 10-3. There's a fastball in there for a strike to Checo.
No one, no tag.
William Carey was due to play Louisiana State Alexander, but that game was canceled.
No one.
Bethel University is at Blue Mountain Christian as Checo hits that hard, but it's going to be foul. Let's see if it's going to hit a car out there. And I think it did. There's a few cars and vans parked way out beyond the right field wall, and I think that had enough on it. As I see some reaction from the fans, so I think it must have hit one of those cars out there. It might have been the vans from Trinity Baptist that parked out there. I think it is. So hopefully Checo didn't put out one of the windows of their team van. And this one's hit in the air on the infield, and that's going to be an infield fly rule. But McGann goes ahead and catches it, and now there are two outs. So TBC can send the bill to Gene Checo when they can assess the damage to their vans. Now it'll be JT Wadley. And Wadley hits that hard but foul to the left side. Blue Mountain Christian leads Bethel, Tennessee, 11-5 in the bottom of the sixth. Middle Georgia is playing Reinhardt University today. Don't see a score on that game just yet. Good pitch by Gattinella to get ahead 0-2 on Wadley. So a tough start to the inning for Gattinella. Walked the first two batters, but since then, couple of infield fly balls, and now ahead 0-2 on Wadley. And that's in the dirt. It's going to get through the legs of Onkst, and both runners will move up. So a couple of runners in scoring position now for Wadley, and one ball, two strikes is the count. Bruton Parker is playing Georgia Gwinnett College. That game's going on, and Wadley has that one out of play, and Georgia Gwinnett's winning 13-4 in the fourth inning. Loyola's playing Louisiana Christian. A lot of these are seven-inning doubleheaders, just like we have here in Thomasville. As it's 2-2 now to JT Wadley. Loyola's winning that game 9-2 in the bottom of the seventh, so that one's apparently not a seven-inning game because Loyola is the home team. And currently batting. Full count now to Wiley with first base open. And Easton Willis is, oh, we have a pinch hitter on deck, so we'll see who that is. And he's hoping on a full count that he'll get a chance in this game as Wiley check swings and is ruled to have gone around. So strikeout swinging there for Wiley. So Nighthawks get a couple of base runners, but don't get anybody across. We go to the top of the seventh inning, last chance for the Eagles. Your score, 5-1 Nighthawks. You're watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network. Chase Marsh enters the game for Thomas and tries to close things out in game number one. Marsh is the right-handed pitcher, freshman from Eustace, Florida, Mount Dora Christian Academy. Coming in for the Nighthawks. Making his 16th appearance on the season. 29 innings pitched. Has an 0-2 record. Opponent's batting 259 against a right-handed pitcher. It's a 4.97 ERA and a 1.45 whip. So pitched a lot out of relief. 16 appearances for Marsh. And innings pitched 29. Right up there with the team leader. Well, you get past A.J. Wydra, who has 64 innings pitched. Leads by wide margin on the next most, which would be Eddie Camelia, 35 innings pitched, and Brandon Steele, 31. And Steele has the most appearances at 16, tied with Jacob Pino. And actually, Jacob Pino just took the team lead on appearances. He just made his 17th appearance. Hey, tilt down just a hair. So Marsh comes in, and he'll face the 8-9-1 hitters for Trinity Baptist as they try to mount a comeback here in the last inning, top of the seventh. And the first pitch is in there for strike one. So the Nighthawks trying to win and get back over 500. We're 22-22 at the moment, and three outs away from being 23-22. As Marsh is ahead 0-2. And then we'll take probably about a half hour break or so after game two is scheduled for 7. We'll see if they try to get it started a little earlier, depending on how this inning goes. The Nighthawks are 2-0 against Trinity Baptist on the season, trying to take the series with a win here as well. Two games over in Jacksonville played in February, and now the return trip, two games tonight. There's a called strike three, so a fastball hit on the inside corner, and Goki is down looking. And that'll bring up Logan McGann. So for Pino, he pitched an inning and a third, only allowed one hit, no runs, had one strikeout. Only threw 10 pitches. So very, very efficient work for Jacob Pino. He was able to get Brad Peacock out of a jam. Brad pitched four really good innings and then got into trouble in the fifth. And with two outs and bases loaded, Pino came in and was able to retire the final out of that fifth inning. One ball, one strike now to Logan McGann. And then he pitched, Pino did, the fifth inning. Or, I'm sorry, that was, oh, and that.
That's a hit.
They're going to rule that a base hit. That ball took a wicked hop on Mike Sowers, and just a bad bounce earns a base hit for Logan McGann. And so now there's a runner at first base with one out. And we're back to the top of the order, Jacob Burke, who's 2-for-3. On the night with a single on the very first pitch of the game. There's a curveball, misses. And then after striking out in the third, he came and hit another single in the fifth. So 2-for-3 for Burke. Hits that hard in the center, but Tefelski is under it, and he'll make the catch out number two. The Eagles are down to their final out, and that's Ryan Aux, the catcher. So we'll see how A.D. Drew and company award this win. Peacock pitched 4 2/3. Did pretty well. He might be in line for a victory in this game. There's a ball hit hard in the left to right, and that's a base hit. The runner McGann will hold up at second, and so there's runners at first and second, two outs though. As Aux is now 1-for-3, also has a walk. And Gavin Williams, a DH, will bat. And now we're going to have a pinch hitter. No, we're not going to have a pinch hitter. We're going to have a pitch runner, a courtesy runner. I was wondering why the home plate umpire was calling timeout. And so the courtesy runner for the Eagles is going to be number 20. Jack Musgrave, the freshman catcher, will come in. And he'll be at first base running for Ryan Aux, who just drilled one into right field for a single. So Williams, last chance for the Eagles. You know, Chase Marsh tries to close it out, and this is a non-save situation for Marsh. The Nighthawks had a four-run lead coming into this inning. And he gets ahead of the batter, no balls and one strike. Jordan Fernandez is on deck if Williams is able to extend the game. There's a fastball high, 1-1. The 1-1 misses inside, 2-1. The hits are even at 7. Nighthawks have 5 runs. Trinity Baptist College 1. That pitch is fouled back.
It's fouled back. Play. 2-2. 2-2.
And now the Eagles are down to their final strike. The new baseball comes into play. The 2-2 fastball misses high, and now it's full. And the runners will get a head start on this pitch. And the payoff delivery, curveball's hit in the right, but that's going to be into the Nighthawks bullpen. And we'll do it again. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. As Chase Marsh tries to close it down for the Nighthawks and pick up our 23rd victory of the season. And that's a fastball just missed inside. Thought he had it there. Umpire didn't give it to him. And Williams takes it for ball four. Now the bases are loaded. And the tying run comes to the plate. Jordan Fernandez, there are two outs. 5-1, Nighthawks lead, top of the seventh inning. The first pitch is hit on the ground to Sowers. He makes that play cleanly and flips over to Santiago to retire the side and end the game. And Sowers throws his glove as I think he was mad at himself for the earlier play that he was unable to make. But he makes that one, and that ends the game. The Nighthawks win by a score of 5-1. So for the Nighthawks, we improved to 23-22. And for Trinity Baptist College, they fall to 17-20. We'll check on we'll give you an update on how Mr. Drew rules the winning pitcher here and just as we start game two in a little bit, but we're going to step away. I'd say it's about 6:15 now, 6:10. They're probably going to give about a half hour break. We'll probably start to see the coaches talking to each other now. So they're checking each other's watches, and probably about 6:45 we'll come on the air. The game should start right around then, I would expect. So they're still talking and giving the coach an idea of what time we're going to start, but they might try to start a little bit before 7, which was the scheduled time, just to get things moving and so Trinity Baptist can get on the road a little bit earlier maybe. So we'll see about 6:45 for game number two of the doubleheader. Nighthawks win 5-1. You have been watching Nighthawks baseball on the Thomas University Broadcast Network.
No, those was all the same. You split? Huh? No, everybody got their own.
You split Sprite here?
Yeah, it looks like this. Y'all clean me out.
Yeah. Right on, John.
Probably right.
I got a water in here.
I know you filled it up before you brought it over here. All right, now you said, what was up with the pitcher? Because, you know, I was...
Yeah, well, Peacock, I would probably do it. Yeah, because 7-inning game, you get a little more flexibility, right? You don't really have to go.
So Peacock started.
He started, and we were winning 4-1 when he came out.
Okay, so we gave it to him. All right. No loss is
good starter.
Starter.
Moeller. Andrew Moeller.
You don't have stats, do you?
For Moeller?
For both of them.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Peacock is now 2-1. That was the second one. Was 2-1. Oh,
yeah.
And then for Moeller, he is now no wins, one loss. That was his first loss.
We 23 and 22.
Yep. 17 and 20. Our conference record?
10 and 17.
Yeah, I think it is right, actually. I got it, though.
Is that before or after the...
It was 17 or 19.
So they're 17 and 20.
Yep. And... 17 or
20. They NCCAA, right?
Lucky to have you up here helping him out, honestly. You help him out a lot, you know, keeping him straight. And he needs that, really.
And like I said, I don't mind, but sometimes it's frustrating.
Yo. Nah, man. They to clean me out.